Hello student, my name is Bhagdeep Kalam from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to my online lecture series of Basics of Automated System. Okay, today we will discuss one type of tire, that is the carcass type of tire, that is according to construction of the tire. Okay, or we can say design or construction, according to design and construction type. Okay, so basically it is in three types. But before this lectures, in previous video lectures, we discussed the function of the tire, okay, or we discussed about the classification of tire, okay, and tubular type tire, tubeless type of tire, difference between tubular and tubeless tires. Okay, so now we will discuss about the tire according to the construction. Basically these are the two types or three types. One is the crossed type, or we can say biased type tire. Another is a radial type tire, and third one is a cross bias type, or we can say belted bias type of tire. Okay, so let's start. This is three types: crossed ply or biased ply. There is a radial type ply or belted bias type. These are nothing but belted type is nothing but is a combination of crossed and radial type of tire. Okay, so first we discuss about the crossed ply and biased ply. In this type of ply, the ply are run at a 90 degree angle, or we can say the direction of the ply at a 90 degree. Like if it is a pure ply, okay, so the angle of the chord in this ply is 30 to 40 degree. Okay, the range of the ply of angle is 30 to 40 degree. The woven of the chord is 30 to 40 degree. And similar, another ply is over here in a 90 degree direction. So suppose we can say like this. Okay. So these two types of ply run over each other. Okay, so the diagram is showing like this. This is the tread, this is the upper portion of the tire, and this is the ply, cord ply at an angle. Angle is nothing but 30 to 40 degree. Okay, in a radial type is nothing but the tires, the cord of tire woven like a radial, in radial direction, or the axis of the rotation of the tire. This is the like radial type. Okay, this is the good, and over which another ply that is same or similar angles. Okay, next is belted type. Belted type is nothing but it is a combination of these two. Okay, these two is nothing but radial and cross ply. So here the combination of these two, okay, cross and bias. This diagram for your exam point of view, so you can draw like this. Okay. Next, in detail, this is a cross ply tire. This is nothing but is a ply. The ply is mounted on this steel bead. Steel bead. Okay. According to this, like this, the ply in a radial shape comes and mounted in this one. Okay. Similarly, in other end, this one. This ply at an angle is this one, 30 to 40 degree, and other ply is like other angles. Okay, this one is another ply. Here in this diagram, three plies are showing, 1, 2 and 3. One. The angle is like here, chord angle is 30 to 40 degree, another chord like here, this one, and again here. Okay, and this is nothing but chamfer, caching of pipe, ball rubber, and this is side wall. The side wall of the tire from here to here. This is made of the rubber, and this is a tread which already discussed in the previous lecture. Different types of tread shape, and this is bead. Okay, this is the bead. Bead is nothing but this steel wire bundle, and the construction details are useful to show in the how tire technology has developed. Several textile plies are laid across each other. Okay, laid across each other and running from the bead. To bead in the alternate directions, in this alternate direction of the ply, and running at this bead. Okay, first and another is the second one, and this one is the third one. Okay, the number of plies depends on the size of tire. How many plies are used in a tire, that depends on the size of the tire and what types of loading you required according to load condition and your capacity of the loading, we can say your requirement. Okay, that according to requirement plies are increases. Okay, the same number of plies is used on the crown and the sidewall. Same number of plies are used on the crown and side wall. Side wall is nothing but these are the side wall, and crown is the topmost crown. Okay, topmost organ is the crown. Cross ply and bisply, what happened in this type? This is the cross. Okay, when load comes like here under loading condition, the tire is moved like that, makes a it overflated, so that the middle portion is up and downward portion is with the grip. Okay, traction is provided only here. Okay, in this diagram, traction is only here. Okay, and this portion is contactless with the road. So that what happened here, the gear is not uniform over the tire. Okay, so area is like one. The contact area is only this one. Okay, under the loading condition. Next is radial ply tire. Radial ply tire is nothing but the cord in this way. Okay, radial way. These are the plies. Okay, and over which steel belt are provided. The main thing is that in radial body plies, the steel belt are provided. Steel belt supports the all the plies, or which can prevent it, or we can say protected to radial body plies. Okay, and sidewall, when load is coming, sidewall are the deformed. Okay, deformed because it is a flexible and it is made of the rubber. Okay, but plies, cord of plies is made of nylon or different types of material. Okay, basically it is a rayon or nylon. Okay, so radial ply tire consists of carcass ply formed by textile are running from one bead to other one, running from one bead. Okay, starting from here and over the another bead. Okay, each ply which is laid in the arc at an angle of 90 degree, each ply is at an angle of 90 degree to the direction of tire rolls. Okay, if tire rolls direction is like this, okay, each ply is laid on this bead. Okay, at the top of tire crown, top of the tire crown under the lid, okay, top of the tire crown, this portion, okay, this portion, we can say this portion, there is a belt made of the several plies. Okay, there is a belt made of the several plies reinforced, or we can say reinforced, okay, because of steel is here. Okay, and steel and other materials between the plies. Okay, with metal wire laid on the top of the carcass ply. This crown plies laid on top of the other overlap at an angle of determined by the type of tire. Okay, another diagrams which for exam point of view, so you can draw in the exam this one, this diagram. Okay, this is the all the things mentioned on here. The side portion is like a solder, and this is a side wall which is flexible, which is made of the rubber, and this is nothing but the bead area. Okay, from this to this, this is a bead area and bead, this is a bead hill. Okay, this is bead core, and here bead core. So in this diagram, all the terminology is shown in this diagram, so you make like in the exam this diagram. Okay, Belted bias type is nothing but it is a combination of radial and cross tire. Remember, the tire tread depth must be not less than 1.6. The tread is not be less than the 1.6 mm over the center or the center. 3/4 of the tire and must go all the way round the circumference in the and continuous unbroken band with no blade pitches anywhere on the tire tread. If radial and cross ply tire are fitted to same vehicle, the radial ply tire must be only be fitted to the rear side. Okay, if you use the rear radial and cross ply tire, if you use the radial and cross ply tire both the tire in a vehicle, that times the radial tire must be fitted on the rear side, not be fitted on the front side. And the cross ply and radial ply must never be fitted on the same axle. If this is a rear axle, okay, so if this one is the rear cross ply tire and this one is the radial ply tire, that not be fitted like this because it occurs ununiform wear. Okay, next, tire pressure must be set to the manufacturing recommendation. Okay, the pressure inside the tire should be according to manufacturing recommendation. If it is more than, if you things like that, the door of the your vehicle is more, that time you feel the pressure more. So what happened at that time, tire may be inflated or overflated or underflated, so uneven tire wear is there. Okay, so the phenomena underflated and overflated may
exist at that condition if your pressure is more or pressure is low, not according to the manufacturing condition. So in underflated, but in belted tire, or we can say radial tire, so in a belted tire what happened, the contact area with the road is increases. That means it gives a uniform tire wear. Okay, the tread and sidewall must be free from the large cut. Okay, no cut on the sidewall. Okay, so you check continuously ki no cut is on the sidewall or abrasion or bubbles. Okay, this is the belted type of tire, that is the combination of this two, radial and crossed. Okay, so it plies provided here, both type of plies, radial type of and cross ply tire. These are the different between the differentiate between the bias and radial. Okay, in bias ply tire what happens, small or medium size engine, it is used in a small and medium size engine, and but radial is used for more powerful vehicles. Okay, another one is a flexible chassis. The bias ply tire type of tire or carcass type of tire which is used in a flexible chassis, where chassis of the vehicle is a flexible, and radial type is used for where rigid chassis. Okay, moderate, and another different between bias and radial, that is a moderate speed. The bias type of tire is used in a moderate speed, but radial type of tire is used in a high speed. You can use it at a high speed. Okay, so it gives more strength, because overall the radial tire gives more strength. Okay, heavy loaded bike. Okay, heavy duty vehicles or heavily loaded bikes, we can use the bias type of tire, and a sports bike we can use the radial type of tire. Next, the comparison of radial and cross ply tire in detail. Okay, first, the sidewall can be banked radially. Okay, radially its shock absorption capacity is more than 25% more than the bias ply or cross ply tire, because the radial or sidewall which is bent easily, because it is a flexible, it is made of the tire, when it is the air and load is comes more, that means it absorption capacity is more in a radial type of tire. Next is braking efficiency on a wet road or on wet surface is a better, because of the greater sidewall flexibility and tread stiffness. That means you provide more and more tread, and sidewall is more flexible in case of a radial tire. That means braking efficiency is more, okay, on a wet surface. Smaller slip angles and higher the cornering force, which is result in a better steering characteristic. That means we require that, or we desire is that, the slip angle while during a turning, the slip angle should be minimum and cornering force be higher to compensate the side thrust which is comes during the turning, and due to turning because of centrifugal force are acted on the tire. So it is desired that the slip angle should be minimum. Next is, while taking a turn, it has less tendency to distort. When you are taking a turn, the tendency is less to distort and lift off the road from the one side. That means you are taking a turn, that means it not distort or less tendency to distort, and it is one side of tire is lifted, okay, in a radial. That is a comparison between the two. Lower rolling resistance in a radial and hysteresis losses leads to less fuel consumption. Okay. Because in a radial type of tire, the rolling resistance is less and hysteresis loss is less, so that the fuel consumption is less. The breaker strip of the radial tire act independently of the wall. Next is, larger the resistance to punctures, that means larger the resistance to punctures, cut and impacts in a tread area. Okay, so what happened in radial, the larger resistance to puncture, cut and impacts in the tread area. That means if your resistance is the larger, puncture, cuts and impact in the tread area is more. Next is, plies, unlike in cross ply where there is a no breaker strip, longer tread life because of less heat build in the tire. Okay, so radial tire the life is a more because it heat build is a less. Next topic is the specification of tire. That is a very important exam point of view. Okay, so what is the specification? On the tire, the written like this. Okay, this number is written like this on the every tire. So what happened of this meaning? This 195/55R1687B. What is the meaning of this? That is known as a specification of tire. That is the standards. Okay, standards according to the standards. Okay, so first 195. What is 195? 195 is nothing but width of the tire with when we see from the front or sectional view. This is the sectional view. Tire width in mm. That is in mm. Should be mm. 195 mm. And this is a 55. What is the meaning of the 55? 55 is nothing but the aspect ratio. Aspect ratio is nothing but height to width. Okay, if it is the your tire and this is a height h and this is a your width. Okay, this is known as the aspect ratio. This is the 55. R is what? Which type of tire? Okay, radial type of tire is used. And another one is cross or biased type. But R is indicate that radial type of tire. Or 16, what is 16? 16 is nothing but the rim diameter or wheel diameter. 87B, what is 87? 87 is nothing but load rating capacity or load capacity. Okay, this is the load capacity. Or what is V? V is not but speed rating. It is a speed rating, the type of speed indicator. That means at what type of speed the tire can use. Next, tire inflation. Tire inflation is nothing but the according to standards or company manufacturing, it gives one suggestion that the pressure inside the tire, it's like that. Okay, this is the, for examples, the diagram which shown you or table which shown you, tire type of tire. Okay, this is a specification of tire. Okay, according to that, the normal load and maximum load carrying capacity or press for what, for that, what the pressure inside the tire. Okay, 32 in poise and 2.2 is in kgf. Okay, and rear tire is what? 30 poise and here 36 in front and 41 is one. Why is it is more 32-30? Because of the your vehicle is a front drive vehicle. If it is a front drive vehicle, generally it is front drive, so that's why it is 32 and 30. Okay, so all the vehicle follow this pressure table, okay, which is given by the company. If it is not there, okay, if your pressure is more or less according to the company manufacturing, that time ununiform wear is there. Okay, so tire may be wear is more. So if it is pressure is more what, or pressure is less, what happen? If underinflated means of the pressure inside the tire is the less than the requirement. Okay, so what happened? The mileage is less. Okay, fuel consumption is more because if it required the more torque or to transmit or movement or propel the vehicle in on the road. At that time, what happened here? The tire wear is here. Okay, only wear, that is the ununiform, because it is not contact with the, this portion is not contact with the road, or we can say ground, and these two outermost portion is contact with the road. That time, the more wears on sides. If it is properly inflated, that means pressure is according to the company or requirement, that means all the portion of width which contact with the road, that is proper wear, that is a uniform wear occurs. And next is overinflated. Overinflated is nothing but the when pressure is more and more inside the tire. Okay, suppose you think that more load on the vehicle, that time you feel the air is more or pressure inside the tire is more. So what happened here, the more area, middle area is contacted with the road, or that means the more deformation or wear is occurred only middle, the side is remains which not contact with the road. That is the drawback if pressure inside the tire is more or less. This is the tire inflation topic. Next is effect of air pressure on the tire performance. What is the effect? Okay, what is the effect of air pressure on the tire performance? This is the last topic of the your chapter. First, on dry road. Okay, on dry road, only properly inflated tire provide the quick response and good handling. That means if your pressure inside the tire is a perfect or inflated type, that means the response from the tire is a good traction, that means wear is uniform. But on dry road, what happens if you are underflated? That means more the area of contact with the tire, that time your effort required on the steering is more. So while you taking a turn, the effort required is more and are slower to respond, and you got a low response or slower to response. Besides, under the inflated tire, also fill out the synchronization during the transition. That is, meaning is that instead of moving in unison in the on a one path, on one track, the rear tires react lagging. That means you required more power. That means lagging is occurs. That means the rotation of the tire is less compared to the front, okay, when moving in the unison behind those of front tires, resulting in the detached sense. That means you sense, like you feel that the pulling action is more required, or the, your vehicle is like a skidding or bubbling, like, okay, in the on dry road, when road is dry condition is that when road is a dry, okay, in dry condition the effective pressure is like this. Next is on wet road. On wet road, what happened? Significantly under inflated tire would allow the center of the tread to collapse and become very concave. That means underflated, that means no water comes out from that grooves, okay. That means water, or we can say lubricant, whatever wet things which on the road, which are the escape on the or which are not comes out from the grooves. That means it allows slipping or skidding your vehicles, okay, through the tread design. Thus, the driving the vehicle with the underinflated tires would be more difficult, okay. Underinflated tire would be more difficult and would force the driver to slow down the retail. That means you feel like that your vehicle speed, you would like that your vehicle speed should be a minimum on that condition on wet road, because some airs, or we can say in rainy season, the water is filled inside the grooves, okay, which are not comes out or escape out from the tire, because of the pressure inside the tire is underinflated, or we can say less pressure according to manufacturing condition. That time its phenomena occurs. Okay, so the chapter wheel and tires is over. Thank you so much.